for me, I've worked in the documentary space as a cinematographer and as a associate producer, but both times I came into the documentary when it was already like running under steam. You know, I came in under principal photography, and right now the hardest part that I'm dealing with in my own documentary is the pre-production phase in just getting this thing off the ground. For me, that's been the hardest part, and mostly because, you know, this thing is still so nebulous that it can change shape at any point. And I wonder, with how many films you've created, do you still struggle with that in shaping your films, or do you tend to come in with a clear, concise idea?
Well, to sort of backdate a little bit on that, those success of those early films, having success is a dangerous thing for a creative, because that causes you to create a formula and just sort of repeat what you think the fans want. And so that took me a little while to break that sort of mold and really get rid of that sort of expectations of what people want it and make it something that I want to make. And so that took a little while. But once I got there, then coming up with the idea and coming up with that process is the fun part and the exciting part. And just so much goes with that. I feel like I'm not tired during that part. Where I get tired is actually figuring out the financial side of it and how to actually make those projects. I currently work with National Geographic in making documentaries for saving animals in different regions. And we did one called Save This Rhino and then another one called Save This Shark. The secret to those ones were figuring out the distribution beforehand and then selling in sponsors on the back end of that. So we got distribution with Nat Geo, then we could go back to Land Rover and Canon and all these other brands to help fund it, because TV shows generally don't pay enough to make it where anybody's really making money on them. So you, the idea first, distribution, then that helps with the funding is sort of the, my recipe with that.
That's an area that I'm more familiar with in terms of, because I spent a lot of my time early on in my career in the television world. And you're right, it was coming up with the idea and then we would pitch it to networks and then they would kind of take care of the back end deals and all that stuff. And then we just had to worry about actually making the show. So it's interesting to hear that, you know, even in your own experience, it's much the same. It's helpful having Nat Geo as a partner. They can reach a very wide audience, and the name instantly lends credibility to the project. And that's something I'm struggling with right now, is that no one has heard of me, so they don't necessarily have anything to go on when I'm like, hey, I'm doing a documentary on this, I'd like to discuss this and that with you. And they're like, okay, cool.
Yeah, you know, like I've come into a lot of those roadblocks too. And what I just sort of do is just start making it, and then people sort of jump on, you know, like make a trailer, even though you barely have enough footage to do that, or build the first scene, and then people could see that your skills, and that usually helps when things hit a roadblock. You got to keep pushing.
Sure.
Yeah, it's funny you say that. Like, so I do real estate development and I've done some startups. And one of the things that I didn't realize in my life until doing this podcast and talking to people like you was there's like a theme. And the theme is, once someone has done enough things, like once they've put enough energy into it, there's a momentum that as the person in the driver's seat, you never feel the momentum, right? Because you got the steering wheel. And so you don't actually know how fast you're going. But at the end of the day, it's like you've actually created a real momentum. And without knowing it, it's actually easier. Like you're saying, like just little things like create a trailer, create a pitch deck, right? And these things start to take a life of its own. And it sounds so frou-frou because we get a lot of people like, what's the tactic? What's the skill? What's the thing? And it's like, you're starting from a wrong place, right? Don't solve for the thing. Just start with the work. Just do the work. And then it's like in the Navy SEALs, they say like, make your world really small. You know, focus on the one thing you need to focus, because focusing on the whole thing, like funding, editing, releasing, you're gonna get into a place where you're just depressed. Because you can't do all that on the first day.
That's right. I like the metaphor of like pushing a big stone up a mountain, and the stone's way too big to push. And if you're just sitting in front of it, just, I give up, I can't do this, then it's done. But if you're just trying and people are walking by and they see you pushing, they're going to jump in and help. And that sort of energy is, I find, true with all these things. You need to really just give it your best push and then people will jump in behind you.
So true. And I love what you said about the honesty thing around, like, you don't want to get caught as a creative doing something that gets you likes. Or I think that's something like, here we are, we're releasing on YouTube. we're talking to entrepreneurs about, I think like high level reality is kind of the way I look at it. And there's a lot of other channels that they'll do like reaction videos to anything, you know, and those videos get so many hits, like, oh, my thoughts on Trump doing this. And it's so silly to me. It's like, let's focus on substance. But to that end, it's harder because you're almost choosing to grow in an honest way. But in some way, it's also slower because you're not going into the human nature of like clickbait. But to me, I actually prefer it, but it can be difficult, I think, as a creative sometimes.
I think as a creative, we should be honest with our intentions and also be vulnerable and really be, yeah, just conscious of who we are and be okay with sharing that with the world and whether that gets rejected or accepted. So that's a little scary for some people.
I totally agree.